Good morning, students. It's me, Sudarshan sir. Okay, successfully we have completed first unit. Now we are going for second unit. See, but one thing, from second unit mostly everything is practical only, so it is not easy to teach in this laptop. If you have certain applications, for example, now I am teaching Excel 2007. If you have this Excel 2007 with you, you just use it. You just go through and you just use it. If you don't have Excel 2007, better follow the video alone. That is enough. After the school reopens, we'll work out in school computer. In school, we have a lot of computers, right? There we'll work out. So don't pressure your parents. It is not so easy to get Excel 2007 free version. We should pay for that. Don't try to download free version because you may get affected by virus. If you have already, you use. If you don't have Excel, you don't use. I will send you YouTube videos. Okay, you follow that videos. Okay, I will send you few video links. You follow that video, that is enough. But those who have, please try it in your home. Try it out. Okay. Last year you studied something about Excel. This year we are going to study more about Excel. Okay. I will teach you the theory part alone. Practical part, I will send you YouTube videos. Just follow it. Okay. There are 256 columns labeled from A to Z, and then from AA to EZ, BA to BZ, and so on till Roman number 4, where this one, see, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P. Does it end here? No, it will continue. After Z over, it will start from AA and then AB, AC, AD. Like that, it will go on. Sorry, it will go till IV. See. It will go till IV, ABCD, IV, from AA, AZ, BA, BZ, and so on till IV, IA, IB, IC, ID, in that row till IV it will go. Okay. There are several thousands of labels, not just hundreds of labels. It has thousands of labels. Okay. The intersection of row and column is a cell. This one. This intersection of, see, this is what? Column. This is what? Row. Intersection of row and column is a cell. Intersection of row and column is a cell. Intersection of row and column is a cell. Okay. That small box. This small box. Row. Column forms a small box. Row, column forms a small box. Row, column forms a small box. This is called cell. See, active cell. This is called cell. Okay. The cells are identified as A1, A2, and so on. See, how the cell is identified. What is the first cell? A1. What is this cell? It is A6. What is this cell? It is D4. Okay. See the column number and row number. That intersection is pointed out in the name of cell. So first one is A1. Second one is B1. Say third one C1, D1, E1, F1. Now this side you see A1, A2, A3, A4. Here you see, here you go, H3. This one F9, like that. Okay, next one. Each cell can store data in form of number, numerical data. Number means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. And also text, ABCD also you can store in that cell. To enter data in a cell, select it. To enter data in a cell, select it. Type in data and press enter. The data now appears in the cell. So, to enter a data in any of the cell, just select the cell and type in the keyboard and press enter. So the data will be stored in that sheet. Don't worry, I will show you YouTube videos. Okay, now listen, then later I will show you, I will send you YouTube link. Okay, next. A formula can be entered in a cell to perform calculations. What can be entered? Formulas. What are the different types of formulas? Addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. These type of formulas can be entered in the in any cell to perform addition, subtraction. It is not necessary to add. If you want to add many numbers, if you type many numbers in the cell, that to 3-3 digit, 4-4 digit number, if you type in all the cells, if you want to add all those things together, is it necessary to add in the calculator? No. You have something called formulas that you can write in this formula bar. This is called formula bar. You can select a cell and you can write the formula in this formula bar. If you write it and if you press enter, calculation will be automatically done. I hope most of the students knew this, because last year you could have worked in that, right? Okay. Okay. Wait, students. Okay, the formula for addition. Addition means plus only now. So it will start with plus. Plus B1, B4, plus B5, plus B6, plus B7. For example, they gave B4, B5, B6, B7. For example, for if you want to add A1, A2, A3, A4, you should write the formula here. Plus A1, plus A2, plus A3, plus A4, plus A5. Okay, so addition will get performed. Okay, don't think it is confusing. I will send you YouTube videos. Okay, next. There is one more way of formula to use, not only this plus symbol to be used. If you have lot more numbers, if you want to add many cells, is it necessary to add plus each and every time? No, you have something called sum formula. Plus sum of corresponding cell number to the next cell number which you want to add. If you want to add all those cell number, first cell number to the last is to last cell number, you should write plus sum of B4, this is to symbol, B4 is to B7. Okay, it will add the contents from B4 to B7. If you want to add contents to A1 to A128, for example, A128, else A200, you can give A1 is to A200. So the contents from A1 to A200 will be added. Okay, okay. Formula where you should write, you should select a cell and should write in the formula bar. Okay. This concept, the sum formula we are using now, that concept is known as function. Sum, this formula is a shorter formula known as function. It will also add the contents. It will also add the same contents which is added here. Okay, both the place same cell only they have used. Here the plus symbol they have used, here sum formula they have used. Okay, if we use sum formula, it is called as function. Okay. For subtraction, cell number minus this minus symbol down, small symbol, minus another cell, it will subtract. Multiplication, cell number, the star symbol, another cell number, so it will multiply. Division, cell number the slash symbol, slash another cell number, so it will divide two cells. Okay, the copy and paste icons. The copy and paste icons in the home tab clipboard group can be used to copy and paste portions of spreadsheet onto another place. This copy icon and paste icon, there is something called copy icon and paste icon in this. Okay, what it will do? It will copy from one place and wherever you want to paste, it will paste it in the another place. For that you have something, a shortcut also. If you want to copy the cell A1, A2, A3, you should select the cell, click Control C, Control C means copy, shortcut option to copy. You can press Control C. If you want to paste these three cell contents, you could have written some content, right? That content, if you want to copy in this zero, you can select the place where you want to paste, and then you should press Control V for copying. It is Control C for pasting. It is Control V. Okay. If you press Control V, it will be pasted here. Okay. Again, I'm saying, don't confuse. I will send you the YouTube link. I'll send you videos. So with that, you will easily understand. The icons in the Home tab can be used to format the spreadsheet cells. See, the icons, this Home tab. See, each and every thing is a different tab. Home, Insert, Page Layout, Formula, Data, Review, View. Okay. The icons in the Home tab will be used to format each and every cells. For example, for making bold, for making italic. If you write text, for making bold, for making italic, for adding color, changing the size, for aligning center, left, right, everything you can do in the Home tab. Okay. To print a spreadsheet, the print area has to be set by selecting rows and columns to be printed and then selecting print from the office menu. So now what is in the sense, you have did a good project, or if you have written all your contents in this Excel, you want to print, what you want to do? Very easy step. Select all those cells which you want to take print. Select it and then go to the office button, give print. And then it will ask the option to print. Just give print the selected area, so it will print your document. Okay. That's all students. Explanation, no more explanation can be given, because this explanation itself you may get confused, because it is not easy to explain practical things. So better we'll stop with this, and I will send you the links. Important links alone I will send you. Just follow that link, and if you have 2007 Excel 2007, you work in that. Else, after the school reopens, we will work. Till that, go through that link alone. Okay. And the homework is, write down the points what you feel important in MS Excel. I will send you links, right? Okay. There we, in that videos, few things would be taught. They will teach nicely. Okay. And, in that, what are the important points you feel? What are the things you feel very important? You take it as you note it down, your homework note, and then take a photocopy of and send it to me. Okay. This is to make sure you are seeing that videos. Okay. Okay, students. Take care. Have a nice day.